Hello everyone, today we are going to see a topic, taxonomicates, which belong to the chapter 1, that's nothing but the living world of a class 11 biology. Before knowing what's a taxonomicates, I will give you a brief intro what's a taxonomy. Taxonomy is nothing but naming of organism and classifying them based upon certain criteria or characteristics is called as taxonomy. Okay. किसी भी ऑर्गेनिज्म को टू नेम इट एंड क्लासीफाई इट बेस्ड अपॉन सर्टेन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स कुछ कैरेक्टरिस्टिक के बेस्ड पे उन्हें क्लासीफाई करना उन्हें नेम करना दैट्स कॉल्ड एज अ टैक्सोनॉमी. ओके, नाउ वी विल मूव टूवर्ड्स अ टैक्सोनॉमिक एड्स. टैक्सोनॉमिक एड्स इट्स अ टेक्निक प्रोसीजर एंड द स्टोर्ड इन्फॉर्मेशन दैट आर यूज इन आइडेंटिफिकेशन क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर कॉल्ड एज टैक्सोनॉमिक एड्स. या टैक्सोनॉमिक एड्स इज नथिंग बट इट्स अ टेक्निक और यू कैन से इट इज एन अ प्रोसीजर और स्टोर्ड इन्फॉर्मेशन लाइक डेटा यूज टू बी दैट आर यूजफुल इन आइडेंटिफिकेशन क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर कॉल्ड एज टैक्सोनॉमिक एड्स. ऑब्वियसली राइट, if you want to classify or identify certain specimens you can identify it with the help of a taxonomic aids, that is a nothing but a stored information, right? Yeah. And next point, the collection of a specimen of a plants and animals specimen is essential. Obviously right now plants ya animals specimen hona zaruri hai, it's required. Without a specimen, how you will identify and how you will classify? So the collection of a specimens is the primary step. That's what? It is the primary source of a taxonomic studies. If you want to do a taxonomical study about any specimen, first you have to go and collect those specimens. Either it can be a plant or an animal. Next, there are many examples such as herbarium, botanical garden, museum, zoological park. Now we are going to see each one in detail. First is a herbarium. Herbarium is a place where dried and pressed plant specimens mounted on the sheet are kept systematically according to a widely accepted system of classification. Yeah, everyone know what's the herbarium is, right? We will collect the specimens like a plant, okay? And then we have to press that plant, okay, under any book, okay? And then there will be a herbarium sheet. There will be a herbarium sheet. For example, this is your plant and you have already pressed that plant under a book. And then you are going to mount. Mount matlab you are going to place it on a herbarium sheet by stucking it with a glue or a tape, anything, okay, on the herbarium sheet, okay. And this should be in a systematic manner and not randomly you can place them or arrange them. It should be placed in a systematic way, okay. Next point, the herbarium sheets also carry a label providing information about a data, a place of a collection, English, local and botanical names, family, collector names, etc. Actually, if you see under this herbarium sheet at the side or at the bottom, okay, at the bottom, if you have ever seen the herbarium sheet, you have to fill certain datas. Such as, like you have to fill at which date you have collected it, at which place you have collected it, even the time at which time you have collected, you have to fill that, and you have to give what specimen you have collected, which plant you have collected. For example, you have to write its English name, local name, as well as botanical name. For example, if you take onion, onion is an English name. Local name, it based upon the state, like jaise piyaz you can write kanda, etc. Okay, that's a local name. How locally used to people pronounce that specimen or in this case a plant? Okay, and you have to write his botanical name. That's nothing but a scientific name you have to write. And that plant, I mean specimen, belong to which family? Collector's name. Who has collected that specimen? All this you should be written in your herbarium sheet. Okay, that's a herbarium. And next we will move to botanical garden. What's a botanical garden is? They are specialized gardens. Okay, it means they are kind of a garden, okay, specialized gardens. Having a collection of living plants for a reference. Okay, they are being, in this case, they are preserving your specimen or the plants, I should say, in a living format. Living plants, you know, they are preserving it in a pot or stuck to a ground. Okay, like in a garden it is, jahan pe different types of specimens hote hain, jahan pe plants hote hain, that you can refer it. Agar if you are finding a new plant, okay, you can compare it, you can know which plant it is, you can identify it, you can study it. And here the live plants they have placed, okay. In the case of a herbarium, it was a dead plant. You are taking the specimen, I mean a plant, and pressing it until it gets dried. Then you are going to stick in a herbarium sheet, right? So in a case of a herbarium, there's a dried specimen. But in the case of a botanical garden, you are going to refer a living plant and identify your specimen. Okay, yeah, next point. Plant in these gardens are grown for identification purpose. As I've said, if you are going to have any specimen or any plant, that in this case, you can identify by comparing or by cross-checking the plants present there. Okay, and each plant in a labeled indicating its scientific name and family. Okay, if the plant has been placed there, na, for example, I would like to give like that, there is a one plant, okay. For example, you take it as a rose plant, okay. There are varieties of rose plant as we know, right? You have brought one plant, one kind of a rose plant, but you don't know what kind of a rose plant it is. Okay, one kind of a rose plant. But you don't know what kind of a rose plant it is. So there, you know, there are different varieties of roses will be placed. Okay, and it will be tagged. Wahan pe tagged karenge. Uska scientific name kya hai. And kis family ko it belongs. So sab tag hoga. So aap apna rose ka plant, you can cross check it. Aur us, and you can know your, you can identify as well as you can know which family it belong to. You can get a data, okay, of your specimen. Okay, this happens in the botanical garden. And you can study your specimen. Okay, not only in the case of a rose, I have given just example, many plants. Okay, yeah. You can study your specimen. Okay, next. The famous botanical garden includes, there are many famous botanical garden which consist of millions and millions of specimens. जिसे आप अपने specimens को देख के compare कर सके, उन्हें identify कर सके, उन्हें study कर सके. And it is beautiful, ना? They are all live plants. You can see them, you can observe them with your specimen and you can compare them. You can know them, have a detailed data about it. Right? Yeah, such as Royal Botanical Garden, which has been located in a Kew in a London. Okay, yeah. How much I know, it consists of 3 million specimens. Okay, yeah. In India, there are two. One is in Kolkata, one is in Lucknow. In a Kolkata, which is there, it is an Indian Botanical Garden. That botanical garden names an Indian Botanical Garden. And which is placed in Lucknow is a National Botanical Garden. Okay. This what is about the botanical garden.